Tell him, I came with the remedy. I came for your spot. Had a drink with your enemy. Came with your ops. Ain't a nigga that's a friend of me. Calling the cops. Ain't no swears in my girl's circle. I'm eating a box. I see what you did. I see what you got. I'm the man for a hire, my nigga. I level the block. I'm the one for a hire, retire. You niggas swash. I'm the one who inspired the kids to get off the block. You see what you did? Now see what you got. A whole bunch of turmoil, and I don't have to burn oil. All I gotta do is milk the game. Boy, I can sit and watch the world spoil. Building all your girl's soil. We know she love a crab boil. Black Rottweiler like Wallace. Cause you rap niggas rap like morons. Nope, they don't really want a case. No, I put a whole face in the face like Zordon. Son, I bring hell so hot to your crew. Won't have a nigga left you could call on. This ain't a court you could ball on. This ain't trap if you caught on. I won't lift none of my hands to the people. Cause I am where lawsuits will fall on. They will settle for a four on. How I be thinking that she jaw on. Competition make them haul ass like a raptor coming out of tall grass. Fourth and one with the long pass. I'm Deontay with the long jabs. It'll get crazy, boy. Don't get it fucked up. Come hit the deck, baby. No navy, but don't push your luck, son. You get an Oshkosh and a baby if I get my looks up. We get you touched up, so we keep it tucked up. Nigga, what? I came with the remedy. I came for your spot. Had a drink with your enemy. Came with your ops.
I came with your ops, nigga.
Ain't a nigga that's a friend of me. Calling the cops. Ain't no swears in my girl's circle. I'm eating a box. I see what you did. I see what you got. I'm the man for a hire, my nigga. I level the block. I'm the one for a hire, retire. You niggas swash. I'm the one who inspired the kids to get.
Yo, 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 what's going on, y'all? It's your boy, First Fam. Chill, man. I'm back. Got another interview. But, you know what I mean? We got a special interview, man. We got a dope interview tonight. You know what I'm saying? Out of Long Island, New York. We're going to give everybody a minute to get here, man. So, you know what I mean? If you just now tuning in, please. You know what I mean? If y'all haven't done so already, if you on YouTube, I need y'all to subscribe, man. Please subscribe to the channel. See the link at the bottom, you know what I mean? Get at us, you know what I mean? We got, you know, we got a special guest, man.
First Fam Radio.com.
You know what I mean? Shout out to True Allah for this, man, you know what I mean? For bringing him through, you know what I mean? So I need y'all to just bear with me, man. We're going to get to it. We're going to have some fun, man. We're going to be talking some hip hop, you know what I mean? And y'all going to get to know Chris Payne, you know what I'm saying? If y'all never heard of him. You know what I mean? If you're following, you know who I'm talking about. If y'all don't know who I'm talking about, you know what I mean? Just go ahead and search him right now, you know what I mean? YouTube, you know, everywhere, you know what I mean? See what he about, you know what I mean? But the, go hard, you know what I'm saying? So make sure y'all tune in. True Allah, what's going on, bro?
Hey.
That's what's up, man. I'm telling everybody, we got a special show today, right? You know what I mean? So if y'all tuning in, man, you know what I mean? I want y'all to go ahead and salute True Allah, Chris
peace,
Payne, man.
Peace,
King. And 4th and 1 Entertainment, man. You know what I mean? I like what y'all doing, man. You know what I'm saying? So, for real, you know what I mean? From one brand to another, man. You know what I mean? I salute you. You know what I mean?
Yeah, King, man. You know me strapping in this belly, man. You know, considering all the shit that's going down, for my wisdom. And it's rough, but at the same time, it's the, That's what make the grind complete to me.
Word.
Without knowing that it's really, you know, in order to get the purification of a diamond, it has to get a proper appraisal.
You got to get the proper, you know what I mean?
In order to get the proper appraisal, you're going to go through some stuff. And in order to go through some stuff, you're going to get scarred, you're going to get scraped. But at the value of a diamond, it been through something. It been through hands. The set has been through something. So that's what hip-hop going through now. Hip-hop going through this transformation, man, that's wicked.
Word. 1,000 degrees, man. For real.
So, you know what I mean? I just built with the God. He said he brought the pause in, so you know what I mean? You know, and you get a moving, but yeah, it's real wicked. And you know, I got crazy stuff shifting over here in this gears, man. And I'm just ready for the relaunch.
Oh yeah, the relaunch, man. That's what it's all about, man. You know what I'm saying? That's what we gotta put our pride and joy. You know what I'm saying? Like when we relaunch, come back out there, you know what I mean? We putting them numbers up, you know what I mean?
So that's the whole thing, King. The relaunch and being able to separate, you know what I mean, the real culture. Let's take it back to the very essence of the culture of hip-hop.
It was
elements in that this generation, because they took that and took it to putting on some demon time. Now, we know back in the days, if we said we was on demon time, then we was worshiping other than self.
Facts.
Peace and love. I'm in the building. Hold on one moment.
So, you know what I mean? It's kind of like, it's wicked, B.
It's wicked, man. You know what I mean? And it's hard because it's coming out at a rapid rate, man. It's like, hey, one time you think you handling something, it's a whole 10 other ones coming in the gate. You know what I mean? So,
yeah, man.
I hear you.
And then the funny thing is how those that be with each other start turning on each other. So it's like being in the wilderness of Zen Zen, man. You know what I mean? You got Young Baby, a little Dirk. You know what I mean? What is all this shit really about, God?
Facts.
What is it all really about? So it's kind of like when you go look at the masses, when you go look back at this, what I do. And the artist development, what I do is I look at all the artists that they had deemed as hot or fire. You go to Dallas, it was Mo 3. So now you look at how that thing killed out Yellow Beezy. Look how that thing killed out Trap Boy Freddy. Look at all that them paralyzed the little young guys for their movement, right? So now you come back this way. You got King Von and all these jokers from Chicago, but they go to Atlanta. And then look what happened with that. So they don't realize the legacy of their craft is dying out, King.
Yeah, yeah. Word. They don't know.
And then you take it to the point to where you start disrespecting the dead, God. That's the universe of karma. Karma don't like that.
Facts.
So it's like, you know what I mean? I just had my young y'all stay out the way. And the relaunch going to set something different out, God. You know what I mean?
Word.
The relaunch going to set up something real different, man.
Word. Hey, look, man, so we're going to get the show started, man. You know what I mean? Like I said, big shouts out to you, True LR, man. 4th and 1 Entertainment, man. Man, this is an honor to have this brother on the show today, man. You know what I mean? I want to welcome to the show Chris Payne, man. That's joining us all the way out of Long Island, New York, man. You know what I mean? So if you get, I don't know if your mic ready and everything, man, but go ahead and, you know what I mean, let everybody know who you are and where you hailing from.
Can you guys hear me?
Yes, sir.
Yo, salute to you, my brother. Salute to having me on board. Apologies for my tardiness. You know, 4th and 1, we don't represent lateness at all. But I will tell you, a part of my grind, you know, 4 kids, 2.5 jobs in the music career. You get what I'm saying? Literally, I ran upstairs from chefing for about 100 people at a banquet at the Marriott. And so they gave me a room. And I ran upstairs and got ready for my interview and everything like that on the 9:30 dot. You get what I'm saying? Left the kitchen, sent in some orders, got a replacement, and came up here. So I'm about my grind. You know what I mean? I have a little rough edges around the armor, but it comes when you know, I'm not a full of an artist of the machine. I'm an artist of an independent monster. So, you know, it takes a little more elbow grease to make things work for you.
Facts. You know what I mean? I want to take some time to acknowledge everybody in the room. Man, I got my co-host all the way from First Fan West out in California, man. I got Mr. Illustrate with us. Mr. Ill, man, say what's up to everybody. You know what I mean?
Peace and love, everyone. Thanks for having me.
You know what I mean? So just to get the show started, man, just for those who don't know who Chris Payne is, you know what I mean? Just give us a short, you know what I mean, synopsis of who Chris Payne is and where he's going.
Man, I'm one of the last Mohegans of this, man. You know what I mean? If I had to say so myself, which I'd rather not, you know, I'd rather let the music and how we grinding on Fourth and One to stay to be the reason things get presented to others. But, definitely, you know, I label myself the Gotham of the game, you know? The rap game is like Gotham. Right. The Black Batman of the rap game. I'm the son of P.E. You get what I'm saying? Literally speaking, I'm able to have that title, and I'm proud of it because I feel we worked our ass off for it, you know. So I feel I'm entitled to say that, and I'm also one of the guys, one of the young princes coming out of Strong Island, New York, the Lost Borough, the borough of Keith Murray and EPMD, and all of them, the ones where who helped start this thing we know as rap, but that borough goes unspoken of. Word. And I was born in Wilmington, North Carolina, where Jordan was raised. I was raised in Bed-Stuy, Brooklyn, around the corner from Biggie. Like, so around the corner, my grandmother went to the Kingdom Hall with a letter. You get what I'm saying? Like that. And then I moved to Long Island in 2001 from a marriage with my stepfamily. And that gave me exposure to the Long Island culture, moving to the suburbs, coming out the borough. Word. Out the borough. So it was that transition. Not everyone gets when you come in from poor to the middle class or not poor at all, or whether you just middle class continuously. No one, you know, that going from that demographic out there, I can explain that. Coming from Brooklyn and then being in Long Island and be the first to tell you, you can get your ass kicked anywhere you go. and you know, yeah. And that's how I feel about it. And so I think people forget that when they mention Long Island.
Word.
And you know what I mean, the borough with waters around it, and where we at now is I'm continuing that legacy as a son of PE.
Word.
And so you know I'm old enough, I'm young enough, and I'm trying to do it right.
You mentioned being the son of PE. Now, are you saying like in a sense of, you know, Chuck D, your father, or are you saying it in a sense of like, you know what I mean, you the next one to carry the torch for PE?
Well, Chuck, like True, is like a father figure. So when I say son of P.E., I mean in that retrospect, but if it was directly of Chuck, I would have said son of Chuck D.
Yeah, fact.
So I said son of P.E. because I'm mentioning the son of the whole label. Now, being told, me, Chuck D, and Professor Griff have the same birthday.
Wow.
So in essence, yeah, which is crazy. It's wild how the stars align, right? And that Leo shit is crazy. But and I never asked for that. I was born into that.
Mm.
Representing Alpha Phi Alpha Fraternity Incorporated, one of the biggest frats to touch the earth, and fraternities, which I kind of shaded away from once I gained consciousness of self and understood where Greek mythology took us as a black race.
Okay.
So I kind of, you know, you get what I'm saying? But I was young when I pledged and being in that light, I pledge as a solo. So I, you know what I mean? And cross by myself too. And in a vigorous frat, you know what I mean? Utilizing my youth at that time in ways where I didn't see it coming, but I kept forth. So I've been almost predominantly trained not to quit on anything. You get what I'm saying? When shit is rough. And that's rare to see in the game now. And you only see it from brothers like J. Cole and Kendrick.
Yeah,
and some of the guys I've run into in the game that I've seen, you know, the Benny the Butchers and all of that. But I feel like, you know, being the last Mohegan or the son of P.E. is not just talking about it, but it's about being about it too, and how you spit, how you deliver, how you come across in musical formulas, how you take the energy out the room versus any artist, the ability to battle, the ability not to make no excuses on the microphone, the ability to go anywhere, anywhere you directed by a promoter or a DJ, the ability to go in this direction, take this motive, cause this mood to happen, and be by yourself when you do it, not having 15 motherfuckers on stage, excuse my language. You get what I'm saying? So I come from that, I take it seriously, and I'm coming from the land of Rakim, and I'm coming from the land where cats like Rakim will point to me in front of the faces of whomever and be like, yeah, I told him he was next up. And or Chuck D to be like, yo, this is my gunner, or telling DJs, push a button and find out. You know, I work my ass off to get those guys who have seen 30 years plus of rappers, you know what I'm saying? And to feel that way about me is special to me, bro. So I'm carrying the torch like that, where this is almost in my blood. It's not, there ain't no Leo Cohen involved in this. There's no, you understand, there's no Double XL. Chuck went on Twitter and told Double XL he don't think anything is coming across the table but me. That's worth it. You get what I'm saying? And this is a guy like True who put me a part of a machine so I could feel what it's like to be in that machine, be a partner of it, stick to a schedule like you would be as a song artist, but also have my independence where I'm able to feel like I can go and bring other things to the table as opposed to him saying anything you do is mine or making me feel that way. I can feel free in my thought process to deliver to the label or to deliver the way I got to bring things. So I think there's a reason why Drake and all of them is older than me. The hottest guys everybody talking about, they older than me, dude. I'm 32 years old. So, and you know, I never seen age in this shit. And I kind of think that's what carried me here. Mm-hmm. So, you know what I mean? If that answers your question, not to be long-winded, but that's what being a son of P.E. means to me.
Facts. Now, you answered the question, man, and I appreciate, you know what I mean?
I was listening to the young brother's music, man, and shit banging like a motherfucker. Yeah, man, just, you know. I'm still listening, still soaking it in, man. I like the fact that he got a head on his shoulder. He, the fact that he followed, you know, and was inspired by P and being engulfed in that, you know, just being part of that experience itself. That's monumental. That's historic in itself. So, you know, I salute the brother, you know. So, right, you know, I'm listening to the music, so I'm getting soaked in right now. So continue the interview, bro.
So my question to you was, you know, at what age did you start, you know what I mean, getting into, you know, hip hop, period? You're like, totally. Because coming from Wilmington and then back and forth, like, you know what I mean?
Brooklyn, man, was like a renaissance. You know, it was Harlem at one point. You know what I mean? Yeah. Brooklyn was, like, especially when we had
Oh, yeah, yeah, fact. So to ask you the question again, man, you know, at what age did you start your career between moving from Wilmington back to New York, you know what I mean, moving around a little bit, you know what I mean? At what point did, you know, you was like, yo, I could pick up this and start doing this thing?
Yo, man, like I said, Brooklyn was like Harlem when I was coming up in Brooklyn. As opposed to everyone was going outside. You get what I'm saying? We had June Balloon. I grew up on St. Mark's Avenue, bro. I grew up on Kingsborough Project. I grew up on Kingston Avenue. I grew up in Park Slope. I went to PS-289, PS-39, MS-51. I've been all around Brooklyn before the transition to Long Island. So it was just quiet because my mom's, it was just me and her. It was straight thugging out, but she was excellent enough and her poise keep me out of the streets enough where I was able to still get renaissance and have a piece of Brooklyn. Because in public school, that's where you learn what demographic you at. You know what I'm saying? The school set, the neighborhoods, the people. And that's what it was. So, you know, the graffiti on the boardwalk at home, you get what I'm saying? It's hard to get that in Long Island because you're taking the bus home to school providers. You get what I'm saying?
Word.
Like the bus is different. All of that. So it's like that right there, believe it or not, to answer your question, kind of is what stimulated the whole thing because you have increased the education in that process. So being in Brooklyn was the ring of sound, like, oh, my first time I opened my voice to rap to an audience was in Brooklyn. And it was at a poetry contest, Best Positive Rapper Award I won. And I was 12 years old and I was in front of my cousin. I was afraid to spit on my first rap. I dropped it on her, and she was like, yeah, you should go. You should go around to the corner and do it. I said, but what if they don't like me? She said, you won't know if you don't go. That was, and I'm gonna never forget that. And I would happen to be by myself. I had a best friend I went everywhere with. He wasn't available that day. So it was like, when I think of it, I was pushed into that moment by myself. I was so used to relying on a crutch, whether you had a hike in, whether you had a, you get what I'm saying? I had to eat that.
Yeah,
I had to eat that. So I went, it was Brooklyn too. So it was, you know, everybody's in there. You know, you got a couple grown men. I went in there and I just let off, like, the first time Joel Cheese heard me, I went off. I didn't care who was in the room. The voice was deep. It was there. Acapella's different than on tracks, but, like, I was there. And by the time I was done, I got the Best Positive Rapper Award. And that was my first award, bought at home. Didn't know where to continue with that. Like, I tell you, there ain't no schematics to hip hop. There's no do it yourself hit. There's no wake up. There's no way.
Yeah.
There's no way. And the reason like even now what drills me to want to do it is because of the loss of the kids, dude. You know what I'm saying? Like there will be 10 years, somebody's gonna waste up their fucking life because they believed Meek Mill. You understand me? There's 10 years you're gonna waste of your life believing you can be a signed artist because nobody told you that they wasn't looking for you. Nobody told you you was not in that lineup of agenda, Leo Cohen and Quality Control and 300 EMT. Because you was, like I said on one of my other interviews, when you look at the roster, half of them is in the grave or in jail.
That's deep right there.
So yeah.
You
understand? Nobody's checking this out. Like, that should be the shit. That's on everyone's agenda. You want to be signed to what? To what?
Facts.
You heard out of your mouth. The deal is dead. Dead. Got a whole bunch of corporations that's just based on these do-it-yourself kits. Couple cats get money. Couple cats get investor money. They want to put some shit together because the land and the way of life now is telling you you can do it yourself. They watch a couple podcasts pop up and want to do their own shit. I get it. Cool. But why, when we watch things happen on an Illuminati basis, right, we be like, oh, that's the higher-ups. But we don't believe that the higher-ups have a position to knock down what we try to create in that same world and realm. Your shit will not reach to where Joe Budden's podcast is at unless you go do some Joe Budden-like shit or you're in a situation where they can extort bullshit around your name. If I was lying, look at the five or six things that happened around Joe Budden's name before his podcast. Everything could be negative for you to look at his in a positive light. The girl he was having issues with, the baby he put in that girl in Love and Hip Hop, putting all on TV, that nigga from Jersey. He's for the bag. He knows them. And I know him personally. You get what I'm saying? Like this. So I know a little bit much and trust. You get what I'm saying? From my own biggest. So that kind of will answer your future question of, yo, with this knowledge, like how am I not on? This thing connects. How are you not on? Like, I know everyone in the bit. Why are you not on? I tell you, think about it. You know this answer. You take a picture. Why are you not on? It's some other shit. It's some other. You get what I'm saying?
Yeah, that speaking on that, like, yeah, before even getting into this conversation with you, you know, real recognize real. Like, I understand that. You feel what I'm saying? So when you say these things, you know what I mean? It's a lot of confirmation. You get what I'm saying? Because you see so much and you see so many people coming through this door. And they like, you know, they ask these same questions like a revolving door. It's like, we're going to keep coming through this until somebody break that. You know what I mean?
It's been a kid like for 10 years. Yo, like, I look at it, well, I can look at hip hop saved my life. I never complain about hip hop. I've seen it in too many dead ends become a flower out of concrete, dude, too many times. You get what I'm saying? We've seen it with the stars that we align ourselves with. Mm-hmm. But then I look at all the brownouts. I look at all the things. I look at trickling down. I had somebody ask me one time, "Why are you always with them old niggas?" You know what I'm saying?
Wait, I wasn't ready.
Legends, but I had to say to him because I'm the right one to pop that shit to. You know what I said to him? I said, "Yo, dude, these dudes get more shows and your favorite new rapper,
mm-hmm.
and we engraved. The dudes you calling old got a toy somewhere that was made. Like, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like Chuck D and
Hall of Fame. Let's say Hall of Fame, man. Can we say Hall of Fame? You know what I mean?
Hall of Fame. They are a toy, bro. Like, were you a toy?
Yeah.
You a toy. He was, yo, I was watching, I was reading the old school Black Panther comic, bro. Chuck D was the dude in the comic. It was a Japanese, like, version comic. Years ago, before I even knew what hip-hop really stood for, I was reading this comic. And Black Panther was looking for Chuck D and put his enemy to ask him about some changes to the world. That shit to me is crazy, dude. That right there is crazy to me. That's crazy. Because what happens is, dudes call themselves big, but then it's big, son. It's big. Like, Jay-Z ain't a toy yet.
Yeah. Jay-Z ain't a toy.
Don't call Jay-Z toy. Call me a whole toy.
Real cool. Yeah.
You get what I'm saying? That is the difference. Like, Flavor Flav played 8 instruments. You knew that? He's the most sampled voice in music history. Yeah, boy. Known everywhere in the world. That's so when I so the end of, even go back to answer your question, I like to see big, you gotta be like, what is big? Because the kids now think big is today. So it's like, you know, big hanging on the wall forever is big to me. That's big to me. You know what I mean? Engraved in stone. That is big to me. You know, Hollywood woke up, you know what I mean, even though it represents system, you know what I mean, that other world, but that some things are big, you get what I'm saying? And then there's some things that is just like, it's so big, you don't talk about it.
Real talk. A lot of people don't know. I don't know if they've been following you or checking you out right now. I'm talking about our viewers. But you got a movie that's on Netflix, you know what I mean? I had the pleasure of checking it out earlier. You know what I mean? It's called Battle.
Oh, man.
Now,
yes, sir.
And when I first, you know, and I'm going to get into you being a battle rapper, but before I even...
Yeah, you know, I heard that battle rap name. What's up?
Yeah, now look, I saw the movie, right? I had to go see the movie because I wanted to make sure, you know what I mean? I knew what I was talking about. I didn't want to just associate it with you being a battle rapper. So most of the people that I know, they was like, yo, I think it's a battle rap movie. And I'm like, it's on Netflix. So we checked it out. Yeah. I got into it.
Yeah.
You was one of the MCs in there. And and it was a co-host. I don't know if it was LJ. Was her name LJ from the Netherlands?
Yes.
Yeah,
they showed me earlier in the movie. I had like the whole ending of the movie, like the grand finale, pretty much. Yeah, so, they did the final battle between the girl.
Yeah, but dope movie though. I liked it, you know what I'm saying? But what I'm gonna say to you is like, yo, that wasn't just your little local movie. You get what I'm saying? That was an international movie, son. Like that was Netherlands, right? And
I filmed in, and we went to Moscow, you know. Harlem, Amsterdam, where Harlem got his name from, and where Harlem, New York got his name from.
Yeah.
And Norway.
Yeah, and Norway. So that one was big. So my thing crazy. Is, man, that's big, just to, you know what I mean, just give you your flowers, brother. That's huge. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I ain't seen too many, you know, cats do an international movie like that. You know what I'm saying? Travel to go do a movie like that. You know what I'm saying? And that's real active business.
Like I said, hip-hop saved my life, dude. Like, and that was an example I made because they wanted, to be honest, like, they wanted one of the sons of the deceased MCs. They wanted, like, Big Pun son. They wanted Old Dirty Master son, somebody to fill that MC role that can bring some bits to the movie.
Yeah.
The producer who aligned me with that, he's on that film Fight the Power that I redid over with Chuck.
Okay.
And yeah, that shit was slap.
Yo, appreciate you, bro. Appreciate you. See what I'm doing, right? You how we move.
Yeah, yo, I fuck with your shit, man. I'm like halfway through the record.
Yeah, I like
it's
how y'all
do that. I'm sorry?
No, I said I fucks with Fight the Power. I was gonna play it after, you know what I mean, just you know, as a segue afterwards, but
the love. But you know what? Just to try to tie in on ends when I feel like this is a calling, like to tell you, it's weird because you know, public, one of Public Enemy's bases is in London and overseas.
Facts.
Before I was ever in the middle of anything with these gentlemen, with True or any, I had that vision of being overseas, because anytime I've had any kind of exposure overseas, they treat us like hip-hop gods, no matter what level you at. Like, the appreciation for what we do is at an all-time high out there. And when I went out there and you see that love like that, you know, you don't want to come back, bro. It was crazy. Yeah. Like, I was like rocking some shit. The freestyle that just filled it is enough for the crowd. This shit is crazy. And so, you know, it was different. You know, in New York, you know, you got to move a certain way to get them on your back. But everybody loves the underdog. You know what I'm saying? So that's the character I try to maintain and keep. But that Netflix movie was crazy, bro. The women was different, like, than America. Like, they're not into drama. You get what I'm saying? Like it's not saying women are into drama, but what I'm saying, it wasn't like it like in America, right?
Yeah.
Because of the world is now, because everybody is under the sun, one know it all. It's almost guaranteed when you say hello to a woman in America, they will categorize you based on your skin complexion and what they see on social media. They watch you in. This nigga just want pussy. Yeah. Like, because he said hi, you understand? Or he held door open. Yeah. Meanwhile, you can be in business with somebody overseas and they want to cross those lines with you.
Mm-hmm.
And it'll be okay. And the business is all right. And you'll be like, what the hell is their problem over in the U.S.? You know what I mean? That's the shit. Yeah. And I got exposed to that, seeing that, and I'm just like, yo, everybody has manners. There's some class over here, even our people, the mixed races, the children of Israel. You get what I'm saying? All around the world. Some of them have the understanding, some don't. But I'm starting to see that, too, when I went around the world. So I thought I was made for it. I auditioned for the role. They gave me the role. Mm-hmm. And hip-hop saved me, because that was a hip-hop moment. And they paid, they asked me. They was like, you want to get money up front, and then you cover your da-da-da-da-da. I was like, no, you guys cover everything. I ain't make nothing on the go-around. I did the back-end move, because I knew the experience was bigger than me just having some pocket change for the role. So it's hard, and it's hard to know that chess move like that when you need some money or you want some, you got a family and everything. But I saw the bigger picture. Because I believed in it. And to this day, since 2018, that movie's still up there. And Netflix be quick to knock down when you're not making no moves.
Word. But it's a good movie, though. I love the movie, man. You know what I mean? I like how they
put it. It's different. Like, it saved the last day overseas.
Yeah, I was able to watch that with the family. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know what I mean? So salute to you for that, man. You know what I mean?
I'm going
to
check it out. What's your thoughts?
I mean, we spoke on it briefly earlier on today's rap music, you know what I mean, versus what you grew up on. But, you know, like right now, like, do you think it'll ever be another, you know what I'm saying, Public Enemy, a new generation Public Enemy? How about that? Like, can we talk on that? Like, do you think, what would it take for us to get that type of feel, that type of movement going again today?
Yes and no.
Okay, talk to us.
What do you want to hear first? You want to hear why yes, or you want to hear why no?
I want to hear why yes, why no first, and then we're going to go to yes. Let's go. Come on, go.
No. I'm going to say no. I'm saying yes and no because I'm human.
Okay.
And I could be wrong, but something could spur right away. The reason I say no is because music has so many politics right now. In general, it always has. But the business has so much politics. What I would say is, Chuck D is the last, Chuck D, Public Enemy, the crew. That's the last you'll see of that shit, brother. I'm going to tell you, because the way they were created with Rick Rubin and the whole coming out of college, and Chuck wasn't even sure he was going to take that job, you know, to be that face of that group. And like, it's a lot surrounding it. And it's like he beat the game, dude. It's, you know what I mean? What happened with PE, the politics, and the money was moving around back in the early 80s, the way the way, you know, Russell and them was coming in, you know, then you had them backers and them, and when hip hop got a little Caucasian, so crazy to the point where it was messing around with numbers and stuff. Long story short, that stuff right there starts to take away from where the journey's supposed to go. Now, nothing is bigger than the Most High and the way he plans his steps. And everything under the sun is done with his mission. But what I will say is, I think the higher-ups that represent the evil, or the higher-ups that represent the steps we can't take because they just may have some power at the moment when you try to make them steps, I don't think they're going to let another Chuck come into business. Consciousness and bringing people into consciousness now, mm-hmm. back then, got you killed too. Hence, Malcolm and Martin is in the ground. Mm-hmm. But now, it's even more dangerous, you ask me. You get what I'm saying? Because their game now ain't even a fight against it. It's covering. Mm. They will cover you. They will cover you. I had E-Love. E-Love is the symbol of public enemy you see around the world. Mm. That silhouette. E-Love is one of the founders of LL Cool J. He's one of my bros. He told me, when I was talking to him about I'll give you some insight how sometimes a game goes, right? I was talking to him, basically, long story short, without putting too much out there, but I'm with you. I told you I was going to do a real show. I had a conversation, 6 degrees separation, with somebody that's partnership with Atlantic Records. Long story short, E-Love knows whom the character I speak of in terms of higher-ups run that building. Mm. You smoke weed with him in college. Me, on the grind, I would do it any rap with you. Yo, see if you can set up a meeting, right? That's how sometimes this shit happens. It's God, you see surface, and you knew somebody who knew somebody who knew somebody. And if it ain't about the skill, and it's still not impressing you on that level, then you know it was favor. That's right. How I get the game. Okay. You get what I'm saying? Instantly. Because then when you go look at cast discography and go back and see their lineup, that's mm-hmm. what's beating that you who's connected to. It's that shit. And that is the reason, to answer your question, why I said no. I said no because you got too much it's too much clutter, nonsense, noise in the business. Like, between me and you, I was trying to make that happen, bro. Why? I did a move, true no, and we talk and we build it. I'm never afraid of it because the universe ain't bigger than God. It can't stop where I'm supposed to anyway. I was trying to 212 with Snoop because Snoop is running Def Jam. So to me, I was like, I could have been outdated in my thought pattern when I was thinking this. But what you think the view is me? Shit, son of P.E. Snoop, the president of Def Jam, he loved Chuck. Well, yo, should see if Snoop should hear me and see what's going on. If they sign as Big Butcher, he'll love me. That's how I was looking at it. Yeah. I put the 6 degrees together. And I'm giving you the visual insight of what happened behind closed doors. No one sees. They just see when the dude end up in source. You get what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. But this is the shit. And so answer your question. I was on a journey to try to do that. We on a journey to try to do that. We didn't have the fucking power. Like, you get what I'm saying? And I'm watching the nation. I'm watching, like, be the biggest news in generation. You know, I mean, Flavor Flav's son by my side, Zach Judah, like LeBron shit, which we got the green light from, through Chuck to have him, because Chuck was the one that got us all of those green lights for the things that we're seeing in the video. Because, you know, I didn't change the beat when I did it. Because my hip-hop term, I thought it was disrespectful to change the Bomb Squad shit.
Yeah, real shit. You know what I mean?
It's a lot in this, bro. It's a lot. Ain't enough in this time. But you get my kid. We're going to build as brothers, you know what I mean?
Yeah, we have an intersection. We got to, man. I appreciate it. Speaking of that, real quick, man. I want to take them into that real quick. And since we talking about Fight the Power, man, I want to take them into it real quick, man. Hey, yo, we're going to come back in like 5 minutes, man. We all got to check this shit out, man. You know what I mean? This my man. Matter of fact, I'm going to let you introduce it since we got you here live, man.
That's love. Yo, this is Fight the Power 2. Matter of fact, Fight the Power 3, because on a musical, the Osley Brothers did it first. Then Chuck and them did. So this is actually Fight the Power 3, if we're going to do it right. You know what I'm saying? That's an example of doing it right. Fight the Power 3 featuring Chuck D. You get what I'm saying?
God, what's wrong, man?
I was overthinking the conference call and everything. I'm, you know, the State of the Union. I'm hearing news on enemy radio about what's going on with the election.
Right.
COVID-19. I'm like, I hear you on this FTP too, but how are we making this happen,
look,
bro?
With the whole social distancing thing, we can't do it how they did it back in Brooklyn in 89. We're just going to have to manifest it our way. Use technology. I got peoples in Europe, get their videos of them protesting and put it in our video. So that way it's bigger than just New York. Now it's around the world. The world is on fire.
What about getting Megahertz Media involved?
You call True Allah, get the guys. I'm going to get the FOIs. Call Prince, get everybody. And we just do it.
Wait. What do you think?
Y'all still gotta do the best you can, the best way you know how. Either way, y'all still gotta fight the power.
Oh, word.
All right, let's go. All
right.
Yeah, I set it off like. Yeah. Like Chris Payne. Simeone. Spit Slam. Fourth and one. 1989, I was born in the summer, and I round off like a number, penetrating your heart, don't you know you got a soul, distribution of love will stop this mass producing of bad white recruitments, I'm like Malcolm when I get on the stand, but like Martin when I give you my hand, it's my solution, give us what we want, better give us what we need, yeah, I know freedom of speech is like copping a plea until we fight the evils that be, fight the power. You see the mastermind solidify the odds. You see it all the time. The White House alive, yeah. Demons in disguise. You spinning just like money. The all seeing the eye. Hating on the Negroes. A chip on Trump's shoulder. He orange like a Cheeto. But listen, my people, we're not the same. Cause y'all don't know the game. We need awareness. This generation so careless. Now you say, what is this? And if they lied about the color of Christ, what make you think they won't murder your life, mom or wife? Huh? Police resting, no. Rush the show, and melanin is my decree. I spit slam the evils that be. Fourth and one when I fight the power. Yeah, fight the power, fight the power. Fight the evils that be. This is the hour. Fight the power. Yeah, fight the power. Fight the power. Fight the power. Yeah, we need to fight the evils that be. Terminator X, Bomb Squad, right? Was a hero to most, but they never meant jack to me. You see straight out racism, suckers will kill you with blows.
Man, but a smidge Jim Crow.
That's that right, and you know we can't walk around without ID. Most of our heroes don't appear on IG. This frequency you gon' get isn't 5G, and you know we won't fight for that war like Ali. I can't breathe like shut up and dribble. Watermelon Kool-Aid, give me a little. Henny on ice, so all stereotypes. They don't want us to read, but want us all in a light top. So what we got to say? To the people around the way. Let's make the whole industry see. Now I'll expose the evils that beat. Fight the power. This is the hour. Out of the night that covers me black as just pole to pole, I think whatever gods may be from my unconquerable soul. Me, my mind. These are the words that do not rhyme. Us and we hour together. These are the words that last for.
Yeah, yeah, we back, man. You know what I mean? We back in the building, man. First Fan Radio, man. I am Chris. Just watched Fight the Power 3. You know what I mean? If y'all don't know, man, y'all could grab that on all digital platforms. It's on all digital platforms, right? Everywhere?
The video is, because I didn't want to sell a song, because I literally hit it like straight off of Spirit and Foot World. I didn't sell a song. That song not for me to make a dollar on. That song has run its race, its course, and it's still relevant to this day. And I didn't look to take no economic pleasures with it.
Facts. We're gonna shift the interview a little bit, man. You know what I'm saying? You got a battle coming up January 31st, man. You know what I mean? Against URL's Reaper Rel. You know what I mean?
Hold up, chill.
Oh, my bad. Hey, listen, this is the battle rap fanatic right here, man. You know what I mean? So he
said fanatic. He's funny. Oh, check this out, man. I just listened to the whole joint, man. That shit slap. I mean, I haven't heard a lot of good records these past years from a lot of these artists, you know, from you got Benny Boom and and El De Blanco and all them. But man, every record was getting better and better. The beats, the fucking, it was the fact, I don't know if you was up in there while the guy that was producing, because I'm hearing the samples and all that. I'm like, yo, he is a student of the game. Yo.
Yes, sir. Definitely inside the studio with it, because I have to be to make sure. Because, yo, everybody's trying to let auto-tune on you, brother.
Nah, and then it was like the album wasn't just on one tone, man. You was exploring different avenues with it, man. Like, you had a lot. You had music for a lot, for a variety of different genres and people. You know what I'm saying? So I was like, yo, for the ladies, the streets, the political. I mean, you hear, you know, the knowledge of self. This brother is like, it's got the core. He'd be like, you was sitting down with the elders, and just was sitting there in your notepad, just taking them notes and shit. I see the picture with Rakim and shit. And I'm like, yeah. Yeah, this album is so salute, man. I fuck with it. Definitely gonna download this motherfucker. So yeah, it's coming out west. Hey, so tell me about that album. What was your mind stand when you was going into putting together this project?
Which project you speak of, King? Let
me see. The loyalty, loyal money.
Loyal money. Yo, that's a special album to me, bro, because I was going through a wild time in my life, and I had just did the previous year, I did Don't Need Your Money, which was my first album ever, studio album, like put together, formatted by label, which was Chuck's. And Chuck actually executive produced my first album. It says it on hard copy too, executive produced by Chucky. And I had featured from the big homie on the record called Promises, which we did for LeBron's school he had built. We was the first ones to touch that school and have permission to walk on the land and property of that school that it was built. And we went down there and we did that record Punches, and we got a video for it too. It was Under the Radar. We really did it for Showtime because they was doing the special on LeBron and his Promise, Our Promise Academy. I'm gonna tell y'all straight up, this is another instance where the higher ups get in the way. And going back to your question of will there ever be another PE, the board that was behind the decision making of how this music was going to be moved around in that LeBron day, they said that I mentioned God's name too much.
Really? Damn. Yeah.
I mentioned not his actual name. Not that I said Yahshua or Christ's name and then and he knew. Nothing along those lines, just God, just, it was commercializing the general American thought, like any artist that would say God's name in the record that they use. I use it like that. You can hear the record for yourself. Ask yourself, is this not teaching children, or are they a little bit too sensitive? Like, so that's what I went up against. You know, you go up against the machine, you'd be wondering, I hit all the areas you told me to. But you know, for religious purposes and da-da-da-da-da. And then you go back to the line that you're talking about, and then you start to see, okay, they want to hit it. And we know this, but sometimes our test borders, even in a big move like that, knowing the truth that they actually hate the truth is much better than me receiving whatever couple dollars I would have got for doing the wrong shit. You get what I'm saying? It was bigger, because now I'm like, okay, I see where I'm playing. Now I know how to go in continuously. You know what I mean? Money's going to come. It comes. When you live, it'll come. You know what I mean? You set this shit up, right? I'm a heavy believer in it. I've been given free since I started this shit. Free showcase, free bars, free songs. I'll hop on this caddy. I'll do this favor. I'll show up here all the way. Did everything you could possibly do. Every platform in rap. SiriusXM, BET, Source Magazine, Londell McMillan's the owner. I know everybody. You know, I know too, but you can know too much and it can hinder you. You know what I mean? I could, as much you guys enjoy knowing that there's somebody out that could carry the torch that still has the OG instilled in them, that shit is not likable to the higher ups. Because then they're like, yo, you're not, your face not tatted. You're not 19. I can't give you this bag and you're going to blow it on holes and jewelry and it'll work in the camera for me to put out shit that we're going to use to sell that will get you shot at the next shit. Because you pop this shit back and we're promoting it. So it's different. And I never wanted to come in the game and be like on the wall, I had a dream speech shit. As you can see, the music goes diverse. I got the club. We got the girls. I ain't even go there. We've been trying to platform the face and platform the messaging. Let them understand there's a mixture. I'm the all-around MC. I personally feel I've been sent to rectify this shit because times where I'm like, yo, fuck this, I'm going to just go drive with a rig truck and make $8,000 a month. Like, it doesn't call me the same. You know, and then I end up back in the studio. Right. And I end up running in like, I chef now, right? I ran into a connect in the business, and they found out I chef. They wanted to chef for Atlantic Records, right? I'm just sharing that with you. I share my shit. I don't mind. That's a vibe, right? I have to say, think about whether I want to do that or not. Now, I do, because you want to get in the mix, but do I want to see what I've been waiting to see? You know what I'm saying? It's that kind of shit. So I deal with that mentally and therapeutically. But having my innocence in this is kind of where I'm at, because then that allowed me to get the best material in the room.
Well, what I do know, you're going to always have your craft. You don't want them to take that from you, because that's like they sucking your soul out of you for their political game and financial game. But you do want to go in there with a plan, going no nonsense, knowing what you want and what you're not gonna tolerate, because you know that you already know what the machine that you're going up against, you know. But it don't mean that you can't, fight at it and get it, you know, get it going the way you want to go. Because I feel what you got from what I heard, just from when the first record I heard was the Fight the Power remix. And I'm really into the lyrical content, you know what I'm saying? The way the artist put the record together, if he's using, you know, samples, is he using, original format and tracks or whatnot, scratching. However, you know, from the Shell Toe Adidas to now, that's my era in hip hop. So I'm going to be real critical with it. And I feel you got what it take, you know what I'm saying? I say, keep at it what you're doing and don't bend and break for nobody. You know what I'm saying? Keep your message the way it is to me. As far as the competition and what the industry is laid out, it's just where you want to place yourself at. You know, they got the ones with the guns and the foolish rap, and then you got the misogynist type rap, the ignorant shit. Now you coming to break all that shit up. So you coming in like Thanos, you know, in a sense. So you pretty much no holds barred.
I think there's a way to deliver all of those messages and still get the generalization. Like, I'd be like, yo, when Big and all of the moves was around, when they dropped, and going even further in the hip-hop, even when the locks dropped, you know, all even in the hip-hop, groups started coming out, 3,000, all of them. You know, groups had their own sound. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like, nobody for a course of 20 years sounded like each other. And that shit was like, not the New York way if you sounded like someone, you know? Right. So I never wanted to like,
No biting allowed. No biting allowed. You know what I'm saying? You know,
no biting allowed.
Straight coming with your original, you know what I'm saying? Your original style, original flow, you know. That was the greatest era to me, you know, because everybody was coming in their own format or whatnot. Things are so microwaved and watered down. How do you keep yourself fresh, you know, when you get in that studio? You know, what is your mind frame when you go in there and try to put a record together?
I'm a cheat code, bro. I'm a cheat code.
Okay.
I can go any like, it depends what's happening. It's weird. I could, like, the chakras aren't going too. I'm a cannabis user, so the enlightenment is there. It depends. Like I said, I'm keep it thorough with you. Never afraid to keep it 100. Sometimes, like in the past, when I wrote something, my writing process is very different. It's not every day. I don't write every day. I could freestyle a verse, and somebody be like, "Yo, that shit was crazy. It's gonna change the whole record." But to me, I know that shit was light to me. You understand? Like, I would know. I've been in this so long. Literally been a cheat code to myself, dude. Like, there's times I've been to ciphers, and I'll be like, I'ma see who the hot in the room. I'll give you 16 from the 8th grade.
Okay.
And you won't know.
Right. It's just how you deliver.
Yeah, you know what I'm trying to say. Yeah. So when I say that is cheat code, like, I was doing I'm making a reference to somebody, Cage. Like, that's why Big been forever. It's like top 200 on Billboard. You've been there 18 years. Like, you get what I'm saying? That's just for a reason. Like, that you be ignoring, like, the shit. Like, you know what I'm saying? It's like, it's for a reason. It's just formula. Like, give me all the chicken heads, Pasadena to Medina, the Big get in between you. It's a cadence, but that pen writing, different from campus. After nonsense, I got the reinforcements, the question the enemy's office with 100,000 offs, the hardest motherfucker on the mic right here. I could teach you a minute that would take in the light. That's different. That's the we've been keeping, even when he's like extraterrestrial, bottle, infinite energy, battling world supremacy. Who only get touched? You cannot bust, crush you with hard jigsaw puzzles and strong jaw muscles. Like, that's the, that'll have you even today. Like, and you like, because they not pulling. And I'm pulling from it. Then you got mine. Then it's my rhyme, my heart. A homie, I like to top it. It's two kids saying money. It's birds and tropics. All y'all need to stop it. The beam of Benz, a bit we saved for, we copped it. Any request you made on Facebook, we blocked it. You had your show. You know, that's kind of, so I'll pull the 90s flow with 2022 references. So they impressed. I'll do a cipher, won't sound like no one in cipher. The youngs will be like, yo, you remind me out of old school, used to give it up. And they'll be excited because they're hearing it and they can't.